Here's O'Hare. Good play, Woodcock. O'Hare again taking it up. Almost came through for Gary Birtles. And Christidis made a very good save. Easy to say there that Birtles should have scored. But Christidis takes credit also. Right across. Situations. My word, his favourite position is in there. Watches the ball comes through, the diving header, and so often he's got goals in that situation. Rather too obvious, Bowyer got to it. Here's Birtles. Woodcock makes the run to his left. Gemmell is a little further back to his right. Still Birtles. Woodcock. Oh, that's beautiful. And it's going to be two for Woodcock, is it? No! Nicolai off the line. Woodcock looks in disgust. He got round the goalkeeper and Nicolai, hands on hips. The captain, watch for him here covering. It's a good move between Birtles and Woodcock. But watch that number five. He's got back behind his keeper. And that is great defending. Gemmell. Well, that's neat. And so typical too. Birtles outside him. Woodcock the other way. Gemmell's shot. Well, if you look at the last 12 months in English football, you'd be hard-pressed to find a better or more consistent or more inspiring player than Archie Gemmell. Whether it's at club level or international level, the little man has to be, surely, one of the outstanding professionals in modern football. This is Bowyer. Oh, he measured that. Thought he'd got it, but he hadn't. Here's Robertson. Birtles near post, Woodcock far. There goes Woodcock! 2-0 to Forest, and Woodcock says thanks for the cross and thanks for the goal. Really beautifully done, and Robertson, this persistent supply line with either foot. This time it's the left. There's the cross, the keeper comes, but Woodcock gets in, and that's 2-0 to Forest on the night. Anderson allowed to go. With a beauty. 3-0 now. And what a lovely goal. The Greeks were appealing there for a foul early on when Anderson first got the ball. Just watch it here. He gets the ball here. And just for a moment, there's an appeal for a foul. But you saw the hand raised. But no, he goes on and picks his spot with the right foot. And Christidis, off his line, couldn't get back. Forced him out, actually, but he's still there. Woodcock, too high for Birtles. It's going to come to Gemmell. Back again for Woodcock, and the two of them at it again. Penalty, is it? Oh, no, this is the referee. And there you can see what happened. Woodcock went past the goalkeeper, who appeared to catch his foot. The referee said no penalty. Now Ross and Anderson. Again, and Mavros away this time. Vajovic waiting for the cross. Far post, header by him, and they get one back. Vajovic the scorer, the tall man there, who got a hat-trick for Yugoslavia in the 74 World Cup against Zaire that I saw at Gelsenkirchen, and one of the goals very similar to that. The ball he thrives on, the high cross to the far post, and Vajovic up over his marker, and Shilton given no chance. Benefiting in these two games, especially in the first leg. Ravusis giving him an encouraging pat on the shoulder. Here's Gemmell. Needham's up there again. Oh, and he got there too, and Birtles got there. Gary Birtles thanks David Needham for the pass. Birtles the scorer. And again, Needham's presence in the penalty area proves important. Archie Gemmell chipped the ball in. Needham had made his way forward again. There he is, jumping now. Just got a nick on it. And Birtles, who prefers his left foot, had no problem putting that away. Robertson. That's three men now. Tremendous stuff. Christidis with the save, equaling this lovely run by John Robertson. He went past three players, right foot shot, and goalkeepers sometimes like those, but nevertheless, a good tip over. On by Gary Birtles there. Well, Birtles getting in again. Near post header. That's his second goal. They were watching for Needham and Lloyd, the big men, the defence. But watch Gary Birtles. He's on the near post. And from that desperately difficult angle, he just gets the flick on. So, 5-1 now to Forest. Penalty area on this side. That's Mazuris. Out to Bajovic. Good control, turn back again for Mazuris. Couldn't quite get his shot in, and away by Anderson as far as Nikoloudis. Now Bajovic. Ardizoglu offside, I would think there. Mavros puts it in, I would think there's an offside. The linesman's flagging, and although the referee pointed to the centre, the offside decision stands. Ardizoglu there will be upset about that. I think he may have been offside to start with. Watch the ball come over here. There's an offside decision against a Greek player. Mavros in the middle, it could have been. It could have been Ardizoglu who touched the ball first, but Mavros put the ball in, and one of those two was offside. Dimatsos, number 10. And the whistle goes to end a great night for Brian Clough and Nottingham Forest. Peter Taylor and Brian Clough going away, having seen their side finish off the job absolutely convincingly. Athens flickered at the beginning of the first half and the beginning of the second, but the applause says that Nottingham Forest, apart from those moments, were absolutely in charge. 5 goals to enjoy and a 7-2 aggregate win in this European Cup second round sends Forest, with Tony Woodcock, one of their heroes over the two legs, sends them safely into the last